everybody, welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Paula. I am the personal trainer and running coach with You Can Fitness in Swanage. I'm putting this video together for beginners, so people that are new to exercise or perhaps haven't been exercising for very long, or perhaps people that have been injured and so need sort of lower impact versions of exercises. I find quite often that people will search around for something to do to get them started, and quite often a lot of circuits classes or fitness videos out there are quite high paced, and they might offer you alternatives, as indeed all of my more advanced classes do. There's always alternatives, but I thought it might be nice to actually shoot a video that's just dedicated to people that just want to work at that lower level, introductory level. So what I'm going to do is I've put together a group of 9 exercises. And they're all the type of exercises you would find within a normal regular circuits class or fitness video that you will find many different variations on. So these are the basic exercises that you really need to get to grip with first before you can then progress on to variations and other progressions. So what we're going to do is we're going to have 2 strength exercises followed by 1 cardio exercise, adding all up to 9 exercises, as I said, and we're going to do 2 rounds of that. Now, we're going to work on each exercise for 1 minute, and then we'll have a 30-second recovery. Now, a minute might sound like a very long time, and it actually is quite a long time. So what I want you to do is to dip in and out as you need to. If you can manage to do the exercise for the full minute, that's what I'd like you to do. But if you find that at any point during this you need to stop and have an extra break, then just hit the pause button. That's the great thing about it, it's not live. Hit the pause button and stop, get yourself together, have a rest if you need it, and then get back onto it. I've given you the minute, but you can just do as much as you can and take the rest when you need to. The 30-second break recovery not only gives you a chance to get your breath back and to have a little bit of rest before we move on so that you're ready to really give it everything for the next exercise, but it also gives me a chance to demonstrate the next exercise that we're going to do together. I hope that makes sense. So firstly, really importantly, make sure that you're cleared by your GP to exercise. You haven't got any health reasons that would limit you from doing that. If anything hurts at any point, you must stop. I don't believe in this no pain, no gain thing. Pain is there for a reason. It's your body's way of telling you you need to stop. So I want you to make sure you're listening to your body, stay tuned into how you're feeling. I mean, obviously aching is okay and that's good. That's just your body adapting, or maybe grumbling a little bit and saying, hey, what are you doing? I'm not used to this, and that's okay. But if something's sharp pain or just a real pain, you must stop. The other thing that's really important is hydration throughout. I've got my bottle of water here. Always have my water close by when I'm exercising, so regularly sipping on that water is a good thing too. Okay, so I'm hoping that you would have watched my introduction video first to tell you what I'm about. Before you've done this, I'm presuming that you've done my warm-up. If you haven't done a warm-up, I have got a warm-up video on this channel, so you might want to come out of this one now, pop into the warm-up video and have a go at the warm-up first. If you can't see it, sometimes YouTube puts all of the videos in a long line, you can't see everything that's available, so if you click on the little arrow at the end, it should actually then scroll across the videos and you might find the warm-up is hidden there somewhere. I had a client who said they couldn't find the warm-up, so I think that's the reason. So yeah, have a go at the warm-up first so that you are definitely ready to start this this session. Okay, so I'm going to take off my jacket, ready to get working hard. I'm going to get some music on. I don't know if you like my taste in music. I think I've chosen an 80s track for this. Mashup of 80s. Let's have a go. So,
10.
We've got a countdown. First exercise we're going to start with is we're just going to start with a mountain climber. Now for this one, I'm going to turn the music down a little bit. Okay, sorry. For this one, a mountain climber, you might see people doing this. This is your normal mountain climber. But we're going to take that right back and make it easier for you. So how you're going to do this is, if you find it hard to get down onto the floor, you can use a bench or a sofa. I'll just demonstrate this to you. So if you're at home, you could have put your rest of your hands on the arm of your sofa or something, so that your upper body is slightly more elevated. And then you can just tap your knees in towards your chest, just walking them in towards your chest, okay? okay? And that could be as hard as you want it to be. And if you want to progress from that, you can start to just jump off that foot a little bit and make it a little bit faster paced, okay? And then eventually you could take that up. So you could do that, or you could do our low level on the floor. Feel okay down on the floor? We're just gonna tap the foot in like this. So on this round, that's what we're gonna do. Second round, I'll show you some progressions if you want to. The first round, we're just gonna tap our feet in, okay? Okay, so all you're gonna need for the whole of this video is no equipment. You might want a mat or a towel if you want to, put it underneath your bottom for floor stuff, but it's not necessary if you've got a carpet really, and you might need a sofa or a chair. Actually, you will need it for the next one. So if you need to get those things, pause it now, because otherwise we're gonna start our 1 minute for our mountain climbers. Okay then, you ready to go? Let's go. So you wanna be on extended arms, and you wanna be in a nice straight line, and you wanna squeeze that tummy really tightly, and then we're just gonna step those feet in. So arms are locked out, just tapping those feet in, or just drive the knee in if you want to. You can slow it down, but just making sure you've got a good squeeze on that tummy and you're not dipping your back down like this, because that's gonna stress your back. So you want your hips slightly higher and squeeze the tummy to give you that stability in your own time. Going, guys. Then you've got about another 5 seconds to go. Okay, well done. The next thing we're going to do is we're going to do a standing squat. Squats feature in nearly every exercise video, I would say. So for this one, you're going to need your chair. You're going to make sure your hips go back and your knees stay tucked behind your toe line. You're just going to sit down till your bottom just touches it and then stand back up again. So you're going to just sit till it touches and stand back up, okay? I'm going to push through the heels to stand up and squeeze your bottom muscles. So, you ready? Let's go. So down we go, touch and up. Touch your bottom, don't sit down properly, and stand up. So, now when you get here, push through those heels to get you up. And squeeze your bottom now, squeeze. Tap your bottom, squeeze your bottom to stand up. Pushing through those heels. Really focus in on getting your hips back. You want to make sure those knees are staying tucked behind the line of your toes. You also want to make sure your knees are not going out too far or coming in too far. If you find your knees want to come in, focus on just pulling them out slightly as you squat. Just tapping that bottom. Well done, guys. 5 seconds left of this one. If you've had enough, then just stop. That's absolutely fine. Okay, guys, and just leave it there. Right, so the next exercise we're coming up to is a butt kick. So this is our cardio move. So we're just gonna take it low level, just kicking. I'll just turn around so you can see what I'm doing. Just kicking your bum as slowly as you need to. If you wanna take it up a little bit to get your heart rate up, you can just take it a bit quicker. That's fine, but we're all going to be keeping it with no impact on this first round, nice and low. Okay, you ready to start? Got 1 minute, let's go. Just in your own time. Don't have to stay with me. I'm choosing to keep it the beat of the music, but you absolutely don't have to do that. So, posture is tall. Down on the floor for the next one. We're gonna do a press up. I'm gonna show you the lowest version press up. There's lots of ways you can do this, guys. Keep going. We've got 10 more seconds. Slow it down if you need to. Your legs are getting tired. Okay, well done. Just rest, grab some water if you need to. Okay, so for our press-ups, we're gonna do a box press-up. So this is the easiest version press-up. If you need to put something under your knees to protect them, like a little towel or a mat, then feel free to do that. You're gonna go on your knees and your hands, so onto all fours. You wanna squeeze your tummy, and you're just gonna bend your elbows to bring your chest down towards the floor. So we're just gonna bend our elbows, chest down. Let's go, squeeze your tummy, chest down. Now you don't wanna be rushing these, so just take your time. A minute is a very long time. So we're just gonna go nice and slow. And don't forget, you wanna just like stretch out a little bit halfway through. That's fine, you can get back on it. So your bottom's up nice and high, your chest is down low. If you can only get down that far to start with, just a little way, then that's fine. Just stick with it, because the more you do it, the more you will get strong. And the lower you'll be able to go. So push through those hands. So breathe out as you're pushing up. So breathing in now, and breathe out. So you push up, breathing in and out. And there we go, that's that one done, guys. Rest up. If you want to just stretch out your hands a little bit, you can do. The next one we're gonna do is called a bird dog. I actually want you back down on the floor again. Sorry guys, I tricked you there. Bird dog, we're gonna be on all fours. Again, same position. We're gonna stretch our arm and our leg away from each other. And then change to the other side and stretch opposite arm and opposite leg. If you can't do that, guys, because the balance isn't that good, just start with the leg. Okay, we're starting now, guys. And then start with the other leg. And then break it down and do one arm. And then do the other arm. Just alternate, but if you can, we'll do opposite arm and opposite leg. Our minute has started. You want to make sure you're really squeezing that tummy. And you want to make sure that your head is in line with your spine, so you're not looking up like this, because that's not good. So keep your head so that your eyes are facing the ground directly underneath you. So opposite arm, opposite leg, and you're aiming to get as straight a line as you can. Squeezing that glute, squeezing that tummy, stretching out. And this is a really good core stabilizing exercise. Going to help you in your everyday life, actually. You get a good, strong core. Now remember, if you can't get the balance to do that, you can break that one down. But we're finished on that one already, guys. So, the next one we've got is jumping jacks. So we are coming up standing now. We're going to do half jacks for this round. And half jack is just stepping out to the side with the same arm. You raise that arm. So stepping out to the side, and then the other side. Now, if you can't do half jacks like that, because the coordination is a little bit too tricky, just start with a leg, and then when you're ready to, just join in the arm by even just reaching up. Okay, let's start, guys, so we can take it over and over. Now, if you want to speed them up, you can do it like this. We step out, and we reach with the arm. But remember, break it down if you need to. Just step it with the legs, and then when you're ready to even just raise an arm, don't worry about leaning it over, just raise it up. If that's challenging enough from a coordination point of view, otherwise, we can take it up to whatever pace you've got. These are half jacks. Looking good, guys, keep it going. Now, probably one exercise that puts fear into everybody when they hear the word burpees. We're gonna have a go at that next, guys. We're gonna break it right down. The lowest version. And with time, you'll be able to complete a full burpee. Okay, relax there. So, I can start showing you this straight away. Low version burpee. So this would be a high version burpee. We're gonna touch down, jump out, jump in, jump up, okay? But we're gonna do a lower one. So your hands are gonna come down. You're gonna step your feet out, you're gonna step your feet in, and you're gonna stand up. We're not gonna rush it, and that's all you're gonna do. Crouch, step out, squeeze your tummy, nice straight plank line. Step in, Stand up. Let's have a go, guys. Crouch down. Step your legs out. Squeeze your tummy. Strong plank line. Back in and up. Don't rush it, or you might get dizzy. If you feel like you want to work a little bit harder, then jump your legs back in again and stand up. Crouch down, step your legs out, jump your legs back in and stand up. Otherwise, you can just stay with the stepping in and out, that's fine. Ten seconds to go. There we go. Nice work, guys. Next one we've got is a glute bridge. So we're going to hit down on the ground again. You're going to lay on your back, switch me first. You want your heels to be fairly close to your bottom, not ridiculously close, but fairly. But if they're far away, you're going to be working those hamstrings. We want to work your bottom muscles. So, heels close. You're going to squeeze your bottom before you lift your hips up high and then almost to the floor. Not quite to the floor before you raise again. Let's go. Squeeze your bottom. Now lift. Now lower. When you're almost at the floor, you're going to squeeze and lift again. Now, try not to think about lifting hips. Try to think about pushing through the heels. Push your heels into the floor to elevate your hips. That's going to fire up those glutes more. Keep squeezing. And remember, if you need a break, guys, you just stop. You can hug your knees in to release your lower back a little bit. Stretch off a bit. And then just get back on it when you're ready. I know a minute is a long time, but I think also when you've got less time, you tend to rush through it. And I'm just giving you time to like practice the technique on these really well, guys. So it's not that I want you to work flat out for a minute. I just want you to have time to think about it, to retry it if you need to. And that's that one done. Okay, our last one is our cardio move. And then we have completed round one. So well done. We're going to do a split jump next, which is literally just to get our heart rate up a little bit. So we're going to take a little jump up. It's literally just swapping our legs and bouncing off the fronts of our feet. Okay, now this could be a small exercise like this, or it can be a big exercise like this. If you want to get your heart rate higher, it depends on your fitness level. So let's go. 1 minute. Keep tall if you can. Slow it down and do it whatever pace you've got. Oh, I am having a bad hair day today. I apologise. I look like hairy, scary, fairy. I don't know what I look like, so I shoved it up on top of my head. And it doesn't look much better. Keep going with those jumps, landing nice and lightly on the front of your feet. Now, I know when you hear this back, you'll say, well, she's not landing lightly, because when I play back my other videos, whenever I'm jumping, it makes a right thud. I think it's the microphone or something. My excuse anyway. Anyway, you just keep landing lightly. Keep it tall, keep breathing. Oh, we're done. Well done, everybody. Round one done. Okay, stop the timer or else it'll start screaming at me. Now you must have a drink. If you haven't been sipping water through the first round, please, please have some now. I hope you're feeling okay. Is it a bit dark in here? My light battery went halfway through my last recording and I need to recharge it. So I kind of thought I had enough light anyway, but I'm not so sure now. Anyway, we're carrying on. We're going to do a second round. It is our final round. We're only doing two rounds today because it's a long old circuit of 9 exercises. We're going to go back to our mountain climbers. Now I'm going to show you, remind you, you can either do them on the bench, hands on the sofa, or on a chair, running them in or stepping them in or just driving that knee in. Hopefully you can see enough to understand what I'm doing there. Do you know what, guys? You can even do them off the wall if you want to. Just stand at an angle, just drive your knees. If that's enough for you to start with, then just have a go at that. That's fine. Well, we're going to take it up a notch if you're okay with it. We're going to go onto the floor, and this time we're going to have a go at running our knees in. But if that's still too much for you, then just tap the feet in. Or you can do a mixture of both, guys. You can do a few feet taps followed by some running ones. Just see what level you're at, see how you're feeling, and like I say, I mean, it's a long time, so kind of pace yourself a little bit. Are you ready? Right, good luck, guys. Final round though, so give it everything you've got. Mountain climbers, let's go. Remember, you can just tap the foot in, or you can do a few of these, and then a few where you don't put the foot down, you just drive those knees in. I'm going to do a combination. This is also a good cardio move, gets your heart rate up when you do the higher version. You just stick where you want to stick. Keep squeezing that tummy though to support you. Fantastic work. Oh, well done, well done. That's a long time to mountain climb for. Okay, squats are next, guys. We did our squats sitting on the bench or the sofa arm, and if that's enough for you, that's all I want you to continue to do. If you're new to squats, I want you to carry on that way. Otherwise, maybe try standing squat without the aid of the sofa. So, really important to make sure your knees track your feet so they're not collapsing in like this. We're going to get those hips back. So not thinking about knees coming forward, thinking about hips getting back. Are you ready? Let's go. I don't want you to rush it. I want you to really think about technique. Try to keep the chest as high as you can. Knees tracking over those feet, but knees staying tucked behind that toe line. I just find you can only squat down that low to start with. But I'd rather you only squat that low and have the technique right. You can go right down, but have the technique wrong. Okay, so this is a beginner's class. It's all about learning these basic exercises. So then you get the technique right from the beginning, and then you can progress as you get stronger. And you will get stronger if you keep trying. Up through those heels and squeeze those bottom muscles. And that's it, guys, on that one. That went quickly. Butt kicks next. Now, we did the low impact, low intensity one. We're gonna add a little hop. Just a little hop on each foot. So we land, hop, land and hop, land and hop. If it's too much, you just do these ones, the stepping ones, that's fine. Okay. Not yet, though. We're still on your break. You ready? Let's go. So little hop, land and hop. We've got a bit of Wither Way music. I'm liking these 80s songs, I hope you are. I hope you can hear them. Just remember, you can drop it down just to a little butt kick without the jump if you need to. But if not, do whatever you want to do with your arms. Have a little bit of fun with it, enjoy the music. It's getting your heart and lungs working. And that's when you start to burn you fast as well. All of this stuff. Strength work. It's all good for fat burning. Remember, if you need to drop it down, you can. Otherwise, keep on it. Because you do want to challenge yourself as well, though. Okay, well done, guys. Don't just suddenly stop. keep marching a little bit so your heart doesn't suddenly come down quickly. The next one is press-ups. So, box press-ups is where you're on your knees and your bottom is sticking out and you lower your chest like you did last time. If you're ready to try a next step up, you're going to angle forward on your hips. So instead of having bottom back, push forward on your hips and then still lowering your chest to the floor. Okay, so you're really on this part of your leg rather than full on your knee, just above. Let's go then. So either version, angle the hips forward to get that bottom tucked in and then lower. Squeeze that tummy. Breathe out as you come up. Breathe in, going down, and out as you come up. Keep squeezing that tummy on the whole way down and up to keep that body in line and secure. If it's too much, on all fours, hands come back a bit, box press-ups. Get that bum step up again. Otherwise, walk those hands forward, angle those hips. Bottom's tucked in now. This is the next version of the press-up. Okay guys, well done. Press-up's done. We're going to stay down. I'm not going to get it wrong this time. We're going into our bird dogs. Do you remember these ones? We're on all fours again. We're going to reach opposite arm and opposite leg. Neck stays in line with your spine, so you're not looking up, you're not looking down. Looking straight down in front of your eye level. We're going to form a straight long line, squeezing that bottom. And try not to rotate your body. Try and keep it nice and straight. Okay, let's go, guys. Let's go with the bird. Bird dog. Don't rush it. Now remember, if this is still hard for you and challenging, you can just do the legs. Make sure you're squeezing those glutes and don't rush it again. Nice straight line, lifting that leg. You feel your glute muscle kicking in. Otherwise, opposite arm, opposite leg. If that's too easy for you, you can add a little crunch look. So you stretch out, then crunch your elbow into your knee and out, and then back. Swap sides, stretch out, crunch elbow to knee, back out to starting, and back. Whichever version of this one you want to do, whichever you can manage, challenging yourself, but staying at a level that you can do. Finish this one off. Good. Well done. Okay, up we get. Cardio. Jumping jacks, we did the half jacks last time, do you remember? Now, you can either stay with that, or we're going to take it into full on jumping jacks. Now a minute is a long time if you're new to exercise, so you might want to do a couple or a few full jacks, then you might want to take it down into the half jacks for a breather, or you might want to just stop. Pause it if you need to, grab a drink, get back on it, okay? Otherwise, let's go. Now you don't have to stay in time with your music, you can do it your own time. Everything is about working at your level. You can move around the room if you want to. Have a look around you. Or you can just stay in one spot, whatever amuses you. Oh, this will definitely get your heart rate up. If you want to do the full ones but keep it a little bit lower, just bring the arms down a bit and don't step so wide. Make it as hard or as easy as you want to. Don't forget, half jacks if you need to, or even stepping. That's okay, just keep moving. Whatever you do, just keep moving. This is your cardio minute, so you must be moving. Otherwise, same with those jacks. Okay, well done, guys. That's second break. Burpees next. Okay, remember the lower version where we crouched, stepped our legs back one at a time, stepped them in, stood up. We're going to add that little jump if you want to. So we crouch down, step them out, step them in, and now jump up if you want to. Okay, so that's the next level up. But if you just want to step the whole time and take the jumps out completely, if your back's a little bit iffy, perhaps just do that one. Let's go. So stepping out, jumping in, jumping up, crouch down, step out, jumping in, jumping up. Whatever version you want to do. But remember, this is the last round. Doing so well, guys. We've only got two more exercises to finish our two circuit rounds. At any point, if the jump is getting too much, take it back to stepping those legs out one at a time, stepping them in, and standing up instead of jumping. Ooh, there. And that's it, guys. No more burpees. Ooh. Okay, glute bridges next. I'm gonna hit it on the floor. We're gonna push through those heels to raise our bottoms, and we're gonna squeeze those glutes as we lift those hips. Okay? Oh, take a breather. We're going in 5 seconds time. Let's go. Squeeze your bottom as hard as you can. Push through those heels to lift the hips up and back down. Don't touch the floor, but almost. Squeeze. 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 Keep squeezing. Push through the heels. Squeeze through the bum. You need to rest, stop, hug your legs in. Release that lower back. Give yourself a talking to, you can do this. Feet down, push through the heels, squeeze the glutes. Woo. There's many variations of this exercise too, but this is your entry level. So that's what we're doing, we're learning the technique, we're learning the basic exercises, and you're done on that one, guys. So, you'll be able to build on it eventually as you get stronger and progress. Split jumps are next, and it's our last cardio move, guys. And then we've only just got one more thing we're going to do after we finish the circuit. So remember, the split jumps were just those little bouncy jumps, light, landing on the fronts of your feet, okay? And you just take it as high as you want to. Maybe, because you know it's the last cardio one now, guys, I know what you like, maybe you've saved a little bit of something. Now is the time to let it go, because this is the last heart-raising exercise in your own time. So if you're just going like this, really low, that's fine. Or if that gets too much, just step the legs back. One after the other. If you're getting really tired, that's what you can do. That's fine. It's your session. You do it your way. If you're not working hard enough, come on then. Let's bring those arms in. Let's intensify those legs. Let's spring up a bit higher. Don't lose anything here. Make sure you gave it your all. Let's have a look. Oh, we're nearly there. A couple more. Oh, and just march it out. Let the heart rate come down gradually, guys. Whew. Okay. All right, get some water. Well, my heart rate's got up. Hopefully yours did too. We are really pretty much done. But I wanted to demonstrate another exercise to you. While we're looking at the popular core exercises that people tend to use and then have progressions from, none more so than the plank exercise, right? You've probably all heard of the plank. Most of you may have tried or done a plank. Some of you may find it really hard to do a plank. Some of you may already be able to do it and you're really hot at it, in which case you might want to switch off this video now, or you might want to just use this time to actually plank. That would be a good idea. The plank is something that definitely improves with time, so I would really say to you, it's such a great core stabilizing exercise. I would say to you, if you wanted to improve on your plank, because it will help you in everything you do in life, not just if you're a sports person, but if you just in everyday life, even as you're getting older, you need that core stability in everything you do, even just for getting yourself up out of the bath or off the chair. You know, we spend a lot of time these days in the modern world just sat at our desks, sat at our computers. So it's really important to make sure we keep doing these exercises, or else, you know, you get really weak in the core. You find that the simplest of things, you're not going to be able to manage very easily. So plank is really great for this, but you've got to do it right. I would say have a go at the plank every night before you go to bed. If you have a go and plank till exhaustion, so just plank for as long as you can before your form stops or you just can't do it anymore, and then that's it, done, job done, okay? The more you try, the better you're going to get. I know it's kind of crazy because it just sounds so obvious, but it is obvious, but you know, it's hard to actually put these into practice. So just give yourself a time, something that you do regularly every day, that you could say right before that, so like before bed, every night, you're just gonna spend a few seconds planking. And just see, maybe after 2 weeks, what improvements you've made. Let's look at the plank. Okay, so you're gonna come down. Your traditional plank on a forearm is gonna have your elbows underneath your shoulders, roughly. You're gonna push up onto your toes and form a straight line. Okay, this is your normal plank. You have to really make sure that your bottom is not sagging down, because if you do, your lower back is really stressed, and that is probably the worst thing you can do in a plank, stress your lower back. So if your back starts to hurt in a plank, obviously stop, but it may well be that you actually need to just lift your hips slightly. Perhaps you're not quite in line, and it is hard to know if you can't see yourself. So, on your forearms, on your toes, and the other thing is you don't want your bottom sticking up, because if it sticks up, that's cheating, that's too easy. So you need to form a straight line, and then squeeze. And squeeze your tummy and squeeze everything, just to hold you there. Your neck needs to be in line with your spine. Now, we're not timing this, because I just want you to have a go. If that's too hard for you, I'm going to show you the entry level plank. So, some people that is too hard, it's a starting point. So you're going to do that, but you're going to drop onto your knees. So I would say, get yourself into your plank position, and then drop your knees down, and hold it there. Squeezing that tummy in, keeping that head in line with the spine. And for some people, that is actually hard enough, and that's fine, because the more you do that, the sooner you'll progress to actually lifting those knees up and just having your weight supported on your arms and on your toes. And obviously squeezing everything in the middle is what's going to help you, and that's where you're going to get your strength from. So, let's do that. Let's plank, let's hold it for as long as you can. Keep breathing, try not to tense up your neck, guys, but you must have that head in line, it's really important. So whether you're doing the knee modified plank, which is this one, so you're just on your knees, slightly angled, squeezing that tummy though, you must squeeze the tummy, or whether you're pushing up onto your toes from there, and just hold it in that nice straight line. And guys, I'm gonna leave it there. I'm gonna sit back onto my feet and stretch out a little bit. And maybe what you might wanna do is to pause the video afterwards and have a go at your plank, or when the video is finished, have a go at your plank and see how long you can hold it for, and just challenge yourself, maybe write it down, nobody else even needs to know what you've done, just competing with yourself really, set yourself a little planking challenge to see if you can improve every couple of weeks, make a little bit more progress, and you'll be surprised actually, you will do. Okay, so I just want you to take a big breath in and stretch up tall, and breathe out and release your arms. And breathe in, and just feel really proud of yourself, guys, for getting to the end of this exercise class, and making a really good start on your fitness journey. And from here, if you keep doing this video, you're going to get a little bit stronger each time. You can make the progressions if you haven't done already, and then from there, you might find that you can start accessing some of the other videos that are perhaps a little bit harder. They still always have adaptions. If you want to drop them down and regress a little bit, that's absolutely fine. But otherwise, thank you for joining me. Really important now that you pop over onto my cool down and stretch video. Stretching is vitally important afterwards, so please take the time, please take the time to do that video as well. Stretch out, and at the end of the stretch and cool down, I've left the music on for a little bit when I disappear out of sight, because it's quite nice and relaxing music. You might just want to lay yourself down, take some nice deep breaths, and just let your mind come back to the present moment and just chill out, enjoy feeling your body relaxing and coming back to normal after your session. So yes, after I disappear, you'll have that music continuing for a couple of minutes. So thank you for joining me, guys. And yeah, if you've got any suggestions you want to make, then please do subscribe. If you hit the subscribe button, then that would be good. And maybe click on the thumbs up if you liked it. If you didn't, fair enough. But anyway, I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you, guys. Bye-bye.